being approved by Ministry of Education and Singapore Institute of Technology was another stamp of approval of the quality and the reputation that our university has earned during the last two decades of its operation in the United Kingdom. And as I said, we are very happy to be able to offer not only one program, but also four programs to the Singapore Institute of Technology and to the people of Singapore to be able to prepare themselves for the challenges of the new century. We didn't come yesterday, and we are not going to leave tomorrow. We have been around, as I said, for nearly two decades. We have gone through ups and downs. We have changed directions. We have responded to the requirements of our society, to the public, to the science, and to the industry. We offer many, many ranges of disciplines and expertise. We have three major faculties: humanities and social sciences, medical science, science, agriculture, and engineering. Our degree programs offered in Singapore are all coming from science, agriculture, and engineering. Our aims, we would like to be, and I think we are, to be a world-class research intensive university. All our programs are influenced by the research that we do. We are very proud of that, and this is what prepares you when you join the industry, to join as a leader, not a follower. This will allow our students to think independently, critically, and innovatively. And this is absolutely important for the challenges of 21st century. We don't want to create or develop followers. We want leaders. We want you to be decision makers. We want you to want to help the industry that you are working for, not the industry helping you to earn a minimum salary.
Okay. The aims of our degree programs, we run several in the UK, but the aims are still the same for the ones that we deliver here. Of course, we want you to have a good chemical engineering background so that you can earn your living, but we also want you to be problem solvers, right? It's not just a matter of passing exams, okay? We want you to be aware of your responsibility to society, the environment, and we also want you to be responsible for your own personal development, so that you would want to aim to become so-called professional chemical engineers. Yeah? And we also train our students so that they can choose their career path either through industry or through academia. If you want to become a professor, lecturer in polys, universities, you can do so. Entry requirements. This is a question that I've been asked all the time. We have to work to a figure. So we use a figure 3. It's a nice figure. So normally we will look for a minimum GPA of 3, but we will also consider lower GPA scores if you got experiences, either work experiences or otherwise. Yeah. So we come back to accreditation. Our Newcastle engineering degrees, our chemical engineering degrees, are uniquely accredited by 3 institutions: ICHEME, Institution of Chemical Engineers, the Energy Institute, and also the Institute of Measurement and Control. Okay. We are the only university offering Chem-Eng degrees in the UK that has these 3 accreditors.
Some of these things you've heard already from Ehsan about the university. We are a top university. We're in the top 20 in the UK. We're in the top 10 in the UK for mechanical engineering, both on student opinion and on research success. And another international survey, I think we were rated 7th in the world as a good place for international students to come and live and study. The School of Mechanical Engineering, I'm head of that school since 2003. We've got about 90 staff, academic teachers, researchers, engineers, technicians, and secretaries. We've got about 350 undergraduate students, growing to 500, that's including students from Singapore, and about 100 postgraduates, total turnover about £10 million. So we're quite a big organisation. And we're quite big partly because we do such a lot of work with industry. A large part of the industrial work in Newcastle University is actually done in my school. But we've arranged our degree course here so that people coming from all 5 Singapore polytechnics who've done relevant diplomas will be eligible to start our degree course. We'll be based at Nanyang Polytechnic, along with the food science program The other two programs will be based at Nian. You'll be doing years 2 and 3 of our bachelor's course, as already been explained, and in our case, all our degree courses are fully accredited by the Institution of Mechanical Engineers and the Institution of Engineering and Technology, the IET.
So moving on to the degree itself, you've obviously got your lectures and you have the core topics, mathematics, mechanics, dynamics, and then you've got control, design and management as well, and all these are very core to engineering. When you go into a job, you will be expected to use all of this knowledge from day one, and the course gives you this. And it is a tough course, but it requires commitment and effort, and what you put in, you will get back. It's kind of a 50-50 system. If you put in the effort, our staff will help you as well. But what I really think was different about the Newcastle course was our focus on the fusion of the knowledge that you gain in lectures and the application of this in practical classes and projects. And so your first year in the degree will start with lots of mini projects, and they generally last a few weeks to a month. And what they tend to do is they take some of the concepts that you've learnt in your lectures and apply them to a real-world scenario and teach you to kind of think in a practical sense. In your second year, you'll come on to do larger projects. Now, these will tend to run for 6 to 7 months, and these are a full project. You will start at the project inception, and you'll actually be working with one of your supervisors or lecturers who will help you decide what the project is, how you want to run it, where you want to go with it. You'll then go through the conceptual stage. You'll be doing design. It's a very iterative process. You'll improve and improve and improve. And then finally, you'll write up your project and submit it. And what did I gain from these projects? Well, autonomy is one of the key things that you'll need in industry. You have to be able to work on your own. If you're given a job by your boss, he does not expect to have to hold your hand through it. And this is what you will learn in the course. You will learn to structure and solve problems by yourself. When you go into a job and your boss gives you something to do on the first day, you can just go off and do it, and you're immediately valuable to him.
Just to give a bit of background to begin with, we've been delivering these degrees now here in Singapore for slightly over 2 years, and it was in September of the year just gone that we graduated very proudly our first 60 graduates from our marine technology programs. All of these degrees are accredited for professional recognition by the Royal Institution of Naval Architects and the Institute of Marine Engineering, Science and Technology. So with that flavour of marine technology, just a quick overview of our bachelor programme. We have the Bachelor of Engineering and Marine Technology with honours in either offshore engineering, naval architecture or marine engineering. The programme, as my colleagues have pointed out to some extent, is 2 academic years running from September to June. Each of the years is divided into 2 semesters, and each of those semesters are 12 weeks. Going then to the obvious question, entry qualifications. Well, these programmes are designed particularly to take people with the diplomas from all 5 Singaporean polytechnics that are marine-based, marine engineering and so on, directly into our programme. The sorts of levels we're looking for, similarly, is a grade point average of about 3, but again, as my colleagues have pointed out, if you're slightly below a grade point average of 3, we like also to see what industrial experience and what your personal CV looks like.
The discipline of nutrition is extremely broad, and this is something that within our research at Newcastle University and the teaching that we provide is essential for a modern day nutritionist. You need to understand the concepts of nutrition from the very cellular, basic molecular level, right the way through to human populations. But the first year of the program, the second year of our degree program in Newcastle, introduces the broad underlying principles of nutrition and food science in the context of healthy, nutritious foods. If you're interested in food and you want to know whether food is healthy, you think you could advise individuals on how to eat a healthy diet, and you can work with food industry, food manufacturers to develop healthy, nutritious food, then you are the type of student that we want to take into this program.